Hello, and welcome to this Texas Instruments training video on design guidelines for the SN65, DSi-83, DSi-84, and DSi-85 devices. This video will provide an overview of the operating modes of the different devices and also introduce and define the key knowabouts for correctly configuring these devices. The goal of this video is to understand how to configure the DSi devices for the operating mode of your choice. To determine which device is appropriate for your application, you first need to be familiar with the different operating modes the devices offer. The DSi-83 is a single-channel DSi to single-link LVDS device. The DSi-84 is a single-channel DSi to dual-link LVDS device. And the DSi-85 is a dual-channel DSi to dual-link LVDS device. The DSi-84 can use the same single-channel DSi to single-link LVDS operating mode as the DSi-83, while the DSi-85 can use the same single-channel DSi to dual-link LVDS mode as the DSi-84, as well as the single-channel DSi to single-link LVDS operating mode of the DSi-83. You also need to know the data mapping format of your display. All of the DSi-80 devices support only JADA and VESA format mapping and 18 bits per pixel or 24 bits per pixel. Another point you should be familiar with is the active and the blinking regions of your display. Look for these timing specifications in the display datasheet as they will be used later for configuring the device. For the blinking parameters, some display datasheets do not list them individually and only list the blinking time. This is fine since the blinking is just the sum of the individual blinking parameters. The particular value for each parameter does not matter as long as they add up to the total blinking. You also need to identify the polarity of the H-sync, V-sync, and data enable pulses in the display datasheet. For example, in this diagram, V-sync is positive polarity driven 1 when data transitions from blinking to active, and H-sync is positive polarity driven 1 when data transitions from blinking to active. For data enable, most displays are actually driven in DE mode, which means the H-sync and V-sync polarity don't matter. In this diagram, since DE is high during active data, DE polarity is positive. Now that you know how to identify these parameters, you can download the DSi Tuner tool to aid you in configuring the DSi-80 devices. Thanks for watching this introductory video. Please reference our other SN65 DSi videos for step-by-step procedures on using the DSi Tuner to configure the device for specific operating modes.